put your hands together for Jesus. Good clapping, and begin with your hands. No spring session, thank you for the moment. For the next 1 hour, we'll keep dancing and dancing and dancing. At one point in this program, we will pause again and ask them to lead us in another session. But for now, let us go on to our program, item number 5. Let us set the tone for this evening's hymn singing. And to do that, let's invite our host, our friend and sister, Otobong, Bassey, to help us.
Program to build a society filled with singers of hymns, both in classical and contemporary. We will be hosting this event biannually in the setting of the Christian calendar, which is the Easter period and the Christmas period. Hymn singing provides a natural vehicle for the primary activities of most worshiping communities. The expression of praise and adoration through the offering of songs to God. Our hymns are both a gift and a statement of gratitude to the one we worship. We have gathered here today for this wonderful concert so that we can praise the Lord and give Him glory as we make melodies in our hearts. We feel privileged for the wonderful opportunity we have been given by our Lord Jesus Christ, who is in heaven today. As we sing to Him, we know the holy angels are here present. It is therefore my honor and pleasure in welcoming you all once again to this hymn concert. God bless you all.
And this is the maiden edition. We are sure that at the end of the year, when we're having the second edition, I'm sure it will be better and greater than this. Let's put our hands together for Otobong Bassey. God bless you. At this point, we will take 3 beautiful hymns. The first in this row of hymns is Holy, Holy, Holy. Holy, Holy, Holy is written by Reginald Heber, who lived between 1783 and 1826. Indeed, it spans many Christian traditions and centuries, unifying them in 4 timeless stanzas.
But Isaiah 6, 1 to 5, Revelations 4, 2 to 14, inspire this wonderful hymn. The next hymn, Fair as Lord Jesus. I have to say, I'm a little surprised at how old this hymn is. For some reason, I thought it was rather new. Perhaps late 19th century, or even early 20th century. But some tradition says as old as the 12th century. And we will round off that session as we sing, All My Hope on God is Founded, but that will be done in Efik as Ndudinyan Kabasi. Let's put our hands together for the wonderful choir behind me as they sing, Holy, 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 fair as Lord Jesus, Ndudinyan Kabasi. The conductor for those three hymns is Mr. Itogowo Rex. The last hymn to the Nkabasi was written by Joachim Neander. He wrote a lot of more hymns, about 60 in all. He was a member of the German Reformed Church and was strongly influenced by Philip Spener, the founder of Spiritism. This hymn calls us to trust God rather than mortal pride or earthly glory. It reminds us that sword and crown betray your trust. It calls us to praise the one whose great goodness endureth forever. Let's put our hands together for that wonderful last hymn, Durian Kabas. We'll go on to take the first Bible reading for this evening. It is taken from the book of Psalms, chapter number 150, from verses 1 to 5. We will invite a wonderful gentleman here with us to do us the favor of taking the first reading. Let us invite Mr. Elijah Edison, JP. Put your hands together for him.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Our scripture reading this evening is taken from the book of Psalms, chapter 150. Wait, 1 to 5, or may 1 to 6. I do read. Praise ye the Lord, praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in firmament of his powers. Praise him for his mighty act. Praise him according to his excellence and greatness. Praise him with the sounds of the trumpet. Praise him with the songs of him the sanctuary. 4. Praise him with his tumbrels and dance. Praise him with strings and instruments of organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high sounds of cymbals. Let everyone that hath breath praise him. He the Lord, praise ye the Lord. Thanks be to his grace.
Thank you very much, our JP. We'll go ahead and take the congregational hymn. All hail the power of Jesus' name, as will be conducted by Otobong Akwa Jr. All hail the power of Jesus' name. I'll sing the last verse and amen. Take your seats. The next row of songs shall be three. Glory be to God more and more, and we'll end with all creatures of our Lord and King. The writer of this hymn, Glory Be to God the Father, was J. F. Garland. It was set to music by Ira David Sankey, who lived between 1804 and 1908. The next song, More and More, was written by John R. Sweeney, who lived between 1837 and 1899. He was born in Westchester, Pennsylvania, on December 31, 1837. He gave marked indications of musical ability at an early age. While yet a boy, he began to teach music in the public school and to lead music. This song urges us to love God more and more for his goodness, blessings, love, care, and most of all, life. The choir will end that session by singing All Creatures of Our Lord and King. St. Francis wrote this hymn near the end of his life. Sick and suffering bouts of blindness, he was going home to die when he stopped to visit a friend at the St. Damon's Monastery. While there, he felt the inspiration to compose a joyful hymn. It calls all God's creatures, sun and moon, wind and water, fruits and flowers, and all who are of tender hearts to sing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to honor our God. Let's listen to these wonderful hymns. Pastor says hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to none other but the King of Kings. Let's put our hands together for those wonderful hymns. Glory be to God more and more, and then all creatures of our God and King. At this point, we have come to what seems like the highlight of this evening's hymns singing session, when we will get to listen to our host. She's going to do a medley of wonderful hymns in English, in Efik, maybe in Yoruba, in Igbo, in Hausa, in Swahili. Yes. Let us welcome our beautiful sister who has made this possible, who has made us come off from all over this wonderful city of Uyo this evening to come and sing praises, not just classical hymns, not just classical songs, but hymns to the King of Kings. Let us welcome on stage Otobong Bassey. Put your hands together for her. Keep clapping till she comes up stage. If you know you are a part of this hymn singing, if you are going to be performing with Otobong Bassey, please get ready. Sometimes, you know, it's possible to get jittery. Yes. When you look around and this is not a rehearsal session, this is actually the real deal. But I know that she's ready, not to sing to us, but to come up and praise King Jesus. Let's clap for Otobong Bassey. A row of duets with the man in white, and then they went into that wonderful hymn, "Come Lord Jesus, take thy waiting people home." Let's put our hands together for Otobong, Bassey and friends. I was hoping that this hymn singing session was going to be very lively, with people interacting. When I say interacting, singing along. As this hymn ministers to you, hymns are completely different from classical songs. If you love classicals, you may end up just listening to them, but not understanding them 100%. But if there's one thing that moves you when you wake up in the morning, if there is one thing that moves you when you are happy, if there is one thing that speaks to you when you are sad, it is a hymn. There is no way you raise a hymn and goose pimples will not fill your body. When you sing "It Is Well," when you knew D deep down inside you, it is not very well. When your landlord says you're packing out next week, and then you sing, it is well. When something crazy happens, and you imagine, how did this happen? And you sing, it is well. Let's share that song together. When peace like a river attended. I want us to sing it together. When sorrows like sea billows, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say. Whatever is happening to me, whatever the devil is throwing at me, I can stand to my feet and say, it is well. I am not just saying it, I am sure it is well with my soul. It is well, it is well. Oh, with my soul. Sing it like you're sure it is well. It is well, it is well with my soul. You know what happens to the devil? He tries to imagine, I am sure it is not well with this young man. Am I sure it is really not well with him? He tries to ponder, and yet you're still singing. It is well with my soul. Oh, it is well. It is well with my soul. If you're sure it is well, move to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 persons and say, my brother, it is well. Give that person a pat on the back. Give the person a warm handshake. This place is getting very cold. So go around and give somebody a hug. Tell the person it is well. Make it 5 persons. Move from this row to this row. And say, I didn't know you had come. It is well with you. It is well, it is well. Oh, with my soul. It is well, it is well with my soul. Jam those hands together, fucking Jesus. Keep clapping if you know who you're serving. If you're sure it is well with you, keep clapping as you go back to your seats. Hallelujah. I am sure it is well with me. You may take your seats. We are going to another session of hymn singing. And this time, 3 wonderful hymns, all-time classics. Praise to the Lord. Amazing love, immortal, invisible. While the choir comes out, praise to the Lord. The author of the original German text is Joachim Neander, who lived between 1650 and 1680, who studied theology in Bremen. Catherine Windwalk brought this text to English-speaking world almost 3 centuries later. The song is a wonderful reminder to praise the Lord for his tremendous blessings. Amazing love. The hymn that we know as Amazing Love, or Can It Be, was written by the prolific hymn composer Charles Wesley. I read varying accounts of the number of songs attributed to him, but it appears that Charles Wesley must have written well over 5,000 hymns. The last and next segment will be Immortal, Invisible God, Only Wise. How do you express the inexpressible mystery of the Creator whose name was unalterable in Hebrew scriptures, save the self-described I am. How do you put into words what cannot be known? How do you sing about the one who is in a fable beyond all words? Walter Charles Moss Smith lived between 1824 and 1908 and attempted this in his classic hymn, Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise. Let's listen to those three all-time classics. Let me introduce the conductor, a man who 2 years ago was a brother like me and then became an evangelist and in less than a year became a pastor and is an apostle. Let's put our hands together for this wonderful gentleman. He holds the Guinness World Book of Records, if it's still there, for conducting the largest choir in Akwa, Ibom. Put your hands together for him. His name is Apostle Akanimo Davis. those we praise to the Lord the Almighty. Amazing love, immortal, invisible, God only wise. Wonderful renditions. Let's put our hands together for them. Our Lord, just to stay put as we near the end of this program, as we slowly wind down, I want us to live with the blessings at the end during the benediction. We have a second Bible reading, and it will be taken by the very same man that took the first Bible reading, Mr. Elijah Edison, JP. Put your hands together for him.
Praise the Lord. Our second scripture is taken from the fifth chapter of the Ephesians, verses 19. It reads, speaking to yourself in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. Blessed be the reading of Jesus Christ.
That's exactly what we're doing here this evening, speaking to ourselves in psalms and melody and hymns and refreshing our souls. We shall take another congregational hymn, Savior, Blessed Savior. At this point, I want a volunteer conductor. Why are people running away? When I mention your name, you just rise and conduct Savior, Blessed Savior. Or else, somebody should just say, Auntie me, Auntie me, Auntie me. Give us a tune in case anybody thinks he doesn't know. Savior, Hobler. The choir is waiting outside. The conductors are waiting outside. So it lies with us, the congregation, to conduct our congregational. Let's put our hands together for this wonderful lady. Okay. Still land. Ibama. You may respectfully take your seats. Thank you very much, wonderful woman. That is how it is. When they say, is there a man willing to serve? We saw a man. Yeah, that's actually a man that is willing to serve the Lord. Let's put our hands together for her. We will take the last row of hymns, singing session. Three wonderful hymns, Rejoice the Lord, Thou Who's Almighty, and Kini Ukbong Me Etide. Kini Ukbong Me Etide is when all thy mercies, O my God. Thou Who's Almighty Word, a hymn which praises God for his light, both the physical light by which we see and the spiritual light of his revelation. Is Thou Who's Almighty Word. The text was written by John Marriott, who was born on September 11, 1780. The song is considered a missionary hymn, encouraging such efforts as appeal to our four elements. Each stanza ends with the theme, Let there be light. Just as God spoke into the existence, the physical light which is so necessary for life on earth, so he has provided the spiritual light of his word through Christ by means of the revelation of the Holy Spirit that is necessary for the redemption of mankind and sin. The last hymn, Kini Ukbong Me Etide, a hymn which rejoices in the Lord and gives praise to his when all thy mercies, O my God. The text was written by Joseph Addison, the author of several hymns such as The Spacious Firmament on High and The Lord My Pastor Shall Prepare. Let us listen to these three wonderful hymns. Rejoice, the Lord is King, Thou Who's Almighty, and Kini Ukbong Me Etide. Those will be conducted by Apostle Akanimo Davis. Let's put our hands together for this wonderful choir that is coming up stage. What a way to almost round off this evening's hymn singing session with that all-time classic, Kini Ukbongmi Etide. The song before that, Thou Who's Almighty God, that ends with Let There Be Light. There's a story about an old congregation that had not light for a very long time. I wonder if it is true, if it is not true. But they got singing that wonderful hymn. And when they got to Let There Be Light, whether it was NEPA or generator or something, there was light. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are nearing the close of this program. We are precisely on item number 14. If you have your program with you, I want to take a very brief remark from a friend who's been here from the very beginning of this program, himself, Barrister Otobong. Please put your hands together for him.
Good evening. Good evening, everyone. My name is Bassey Otobong, and a close friend to Otobong Bassey. I call her Coco Dearest. Praise God. I hope we all had a good time. I sure did have a good time. I want to appreciate God and everyone for the opportunity to be alive to witness this great event. I think singing of hymns to us most times have not really meant a lot to us, but God laid in the heart of someone to bring us together to sing hymns and praises to the Holy God. And with that, I believe you cannot pray, you cannot say a lot, but through hymns, God can meet your needs, right? I want to appreciate everyone for coming. I want to thank the family of Otobong Bassey, the friends and loved ones. I love this group. You guys are amazing. Thank you. The choir, you are beautiful. God bless you for being a blessing to us. I would like to request that we see again Christmas edition. I'll be here. Are you going to be here? Before you travel, Mbok, come for this first. Amen. Otobong Bassey, we love you. I appreciate you. God will keep this vision going higher. In Jesus' name. Have a pleasant evening. Amen.
Thank you very much, Barrister. We would have loved to recognize everybody by name as they came here or as they sit here. But as I stand, I want to say that wherever you're seated, be rest assured that you're a very special guest at this program. You came here to receive from the Almighty, and that's exactly what has happened to you this evening. If you're a man, I want to say you're welcome. If you're a woman, I want to say you're welcome. If you came in as a family, if you're friends of Otobong, if somebody said, come and let's go together, I want to trust that you had fun in the presence of the Almighty this evening. I want you to know that I've mentioned your name individually as you sit and you're recognized, and the good Lord will bless you for making it to this program in Jesus' name. We will sing Abide With Me as a closing hymn before we take our leave. I'll invite a friend and brother, Apostle Akanimo Davis, to conduct this congregational hymn, Abide With Me, Fast Falls the Eventide. Thank you. this little day. Earth's joys grow dim, its glories pass away. Change and the decay
of Jesus Christ. Shall we share the grace in fellowship? Now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Shalom.
On behalf of the friends of Otobong, Bassey, this wonderful choir, this wonderful band, I want to say good night.